Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks again for joining us. I hope you're all well and you're feeling well mentally, emotionally, spiritually, physically. And as always, if there's anything I can do to help with that, let me know. But hopefully this is helpful to you in any of those ways. So as always, sing, dance, think, reminisce, do whatever you need to do or you feel like doing to connect with this and get something out of it. So we'll go ahead and get started with our hellos.
Hail, hail, gangs all ye. What the heck do we care? What the heck do we care? Hail, hail, the gang's all here. What the heck do we care now? If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake. Baked a cake, baked a cake. If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake. How you do, how you do, how you do? Had you dropped me a letter, I'd have hired a band. The grandest band in the land. Had you dropped me a letter, I'd have hired a band. Spread the welcome out for you. Now I don't know where you came from, cause I don't know where you've been. But it really doesn't matter, grab a chair and fill your platter and dig, dig, dig right in. If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake, baked a cake, baked a cake. If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake. How you do, 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 how you do.
So today we will be singing songs about popular songs in movies, soundtracks. And they're probably, most of them are ones you've heard of before and from movies you're familiar with, but there might be one or two that you've never heard of. So the first one is a song we've done before, but it's one of my favorites. I apparently have lots, but most of the time they're my favorites for sentimental reasons. So. This is Rainbow Connection from the Muppet Movie from 1979. Music and lyrics were written by Paul Williams and Kenneth Asher. The song was performed by none other than Kermit the Frog with the voice of Jim Henson in the film. Rainbow Connection reached number 25 on the Billboard Hot 100 in November 1979 and remained in the top 40 for 7 weeks total. Williams and Asher received an Academy Award nomination for Best Original Song at the 52nd Academy Awards.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows? What's on the other side? Rainbows are visions, but only illusions. Rainbows have nothing to hide. So we've been told, and some choose to believe it. I know they're wrong, wait and see. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. Who said that every wish would be heard and answered when wished on the morning star? Somebody thought of that. Someone believed it. Look what it's done so far. What's so amazing that keeps us stargazing? What do we think we might see? Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. All of us under its spell, we know that it's probably magic. Have you been half asleep, and have you heard voices? I've heard them calling my name.
is this the sweet sound that calls the young sailors? The voice might be one and the same. I've heard it too many times to ignore it. It's something I'm supposed to be. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. La da 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 da. La da 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 dee dee da. Excuse me. I grew up watching the Muppet Babies, and at Christmas time we watched the Jim Henson Muppets Christmas movie. Not the Christmas Carol, it's a Muppets Christmas or something like that. And it's funny and brings back, it's a tradition we'd have in my house. So that's why I love the Muppets so much. All right, next is Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head. It was written by Hal David and Burt Bacharach for the 1969 film. Anybody know? Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid. It won an Oscar for the Best Original Song. It also won Best Original Score. The song was recorded by B.J. Thomas in 7 takes after Bacharach expressed dissatisfaction with the first 6. The film version of the song, Thomas had been recovering from laryngitis, which made his voice sound more abrasive than in the 7-inch release. The film version featured a separate vaudeville-style instrumental break, double time, while Paul Newman performed bicycle stunts. So, Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head. Falling on my head, and just like the guy whose feet are too big for his bed, nothing seems to fit. Those raindrops are falling on my head, they keep falling. So I just did me some talking to the sun. I said I didn't like the way he got things done, sleeping on the job. Those raindrops are falling on my head, they keep falling. But there's one thing I know. The news they sent to meet me won't defeat me. It won't be long till happiness steps up to greet me. Raindrops keep falling on my head. That doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me, 'cause I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining, because I'm free. Nothing's worrying me. Unchained Melody. I'm sure you all know this one well. A 1955 song, with music by Alex North and lyrics by Hi Zarrett. Excuse me, I have a tickle today. North wrote the music as a theme for the little-known prison film Unchained in January 1955, hence the title. Todd Duncan sang the vocals for the film soundtrack. It has since become a standard and one of the most recorded songs of the 20th century, most notably by the Righteous Brothers. According to the song's publishing administrator, over 1,500 recordings of Unchained Melody have been made by more than 670 artists in multiple languages. So, excuse me, without further ado, Unchained Melody.
I've hung prepared for your touch along lonely time. And time goes by so slowly, and time can do so much. Are you still mine? Godspeed your love to me. Lonely rivers flow to the sea. To the sea, to the open arms of the sea. Lonely riverside, wait for me, wait for me. I'll be coming home, wait for me. Oh, my love. I've hungered for your touch along lonely time. And time goes by so slowly, and time can do so much. Are you still mine? I need your love. I need your love. Godspeed your love to me.
Sweet song. All right. And here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. Sung by Simon and Garfunkel in their fourth studio album, Bookends. Produced by the duo Roy Haley, it's famous for the inclusion in the 1967 film, The Graduate. It was written by Paul Simon, who pitched it to the director, Mike Nichols, alongside Art Garfunkel, after Nichols rejected two other songs intended for the film. This song contains famous reference to the baseball star, Joe DiMaggio. It became their second chart topper, hitting number one on the Billboard Hot 100, as well as peaking within the top 10 in the UK, Ireland, and Spain, among other countries. In 1969, it became the first rock song to win the Grammy Award for Record of the Year. It's been covered by numbers of artists, including Frank Sinatra, the Lemonheads, and Bon Jovi. In 2004, it finished at number 6 on AFI's 100 Years, 100 Songs Surveys of Top Tunes in American Cinema. So, see if I can do it justice. Thank you.
Here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven holds a place for those who pray. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. We'd like to know a little about you for our files. We'd like to help you learn to help yourself. Look around you, all you see are sympathetic eyes. Stroll around the grounds until you feel at home. Here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven holds a place for those who pray. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. Hiding in a hiding place where no one ever goes. Put it in your pantry with your cupcakes. It's a little secret, just the Robinson's affair. Most of all, you got to hide it from the kids. Goo goo choo, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven holds a place for those who pray. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. Sitting on a sofa on a Sunday afternoon, do the candidates debate. Laugh about it, shout about it when you got to choose. Every way you look at it, you lose. Where have you gone, Joe DiMaggio? The nation turns its lonely eyes to you. Ooh, what's that you say, Mrs. Robinson? Joel to Joel has left and gone away. Hey, 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 hey.
I know it's not the original, but that's what I can do. I just learned that yesterday, so hopefully I did okay. All right, how about Moon River? This one, I'm sure you can all think of which one this one's from. It's from a very classic movie. It was composed by Henry Mancini with lyrics by Johnny Mercer. And it was originally performed by Audrey Hepburn in the 1961 movie. Any guesses? Breakfast at Tiffany's, and it won an Academy Award for Best Original Song. It also won on the 1962 Grammy Awards for Record of the Year and Song of the Year. It's been covered by many other artists. It became a theme song for Andy Williams, who first recorded it in 1962 and performed it at the Academy Awards that year. He sang the first 8 bars of the song at the beginning of each episode of his television show and named his production company and venue in Branson, Missouri after it. His autobiography is called Moon River and Me. His version was never released as a single, but it charted as an LP track that he recorded for Columbia on a hit album of 1962, Moon River and other great movie themes. So, another one of my favorites, Moon River.
I'm crossing you in style someday. Oh, dream maker, you heartbreaker, wherever you're going, your way. Two drifters love to see the world. There's such a lot of world to see. We're after the same rainbows and waiting round the bend. My huckleberry friend, the river and me. Love to see the world. There's such a lot of worlds to see. We're after the same rainbows and waiting round the bend. My huckleberry friend, river and me.
Somewhere, my love. Anybody know where that one's from? Dr. Zhivago. Maurice Jarre was asked by director David Lean to come up with a theme for the character of Laura, played by Julie Christie. Initially, Leah had desired to use a well-known Russian song, but could not locate the rights to it, and delegated responsibility to Jarre. After several unsuccessful attempts at writing it, Lean suggested to Jarre that he go to the mountains with his girlfriend and write a piece of music for her. Jarre says that the results piece was Laura's theme, and Lean liked it well enough to use it in numerous tracks for the film. In editing Zhivago, Lean and producer Carlo Ponti reduced or outright deleted many of the themes composed by Jarre, and he was angry about this because he felt an over-reliance on Laura's theme would ruin the soundtrack. So, lots of controversy with this one. Somewhere, My Love.
Somewhere, my love, there will be songs to sing. Although the snow covers the hope of spring, somewhere a hill blossoms and green and gold, and there are dreams, all that your heart can hold. Someday we'll meet again, my love. Someday, whenever the spring breaks through, you'll come to me out of the long ago, warm as the wind, soft as the kiss of snow. Till then, my sweet, think of me now and then. Godspeed, my love, till you are mine again.
I learned that one for somebody I used to visit probably several years ago. But he sure loved talking about it, Dr. Zhivago. So I always think of him when I hear that song, when I play that song. Okay, Que Sera Sera, Whatever Will Be, is written by the team of Jay Livingston and Ray Evans. That was first published in 1956. Doris Day introduced it in the Alfred Hitchcock film The Man Who Knew Too Much in 1956, singing it as a cue to their on-screen kidnapped son. The four verses of the song progress through the life of the narrator from childhood through young adult and to falling in love to parenthood, and each asks, what will I be or what lies ahead? And the chorus repeats, what will be." Day's recording of the song for Columbia Records made it to number 2 on the Billboard Hot 100 and number 1 in the UK singles chart. It came to be known as Day's signature song. The song in The Man Who Knew Too Much received 1956 Academy Award for Best Original Song and was the third Oscar in this category for Livingston and Evans, who previously won in 1948 and 1950. It was a number one hit in Australia for pop singer Normie Rowe in September of 1965. And the song popularized the title expression, Que sera, sera, as an English language phrase indicating cheerful fatalism through its use in English dates back to the 16th century. Contrary to popular perception, the phrase is not Spanish in origin and is not grammatical in that language.
Just a little girl, I asked my mother, what will I be? Will I be pretty? Will I be rich? Here's what she said to me. Que sera, sera, whatever will be, the future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera, what will be. When I grew up and fell in love, I asked my sweetheart what lies ahead. Will we have rainbows day after day? Here's what my sweetheart said. Que sera, sera, whatever will be, the future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera, what will be. Now I have children of my own, they ask their mother, what will I be? Will I be handsome? Will I be rich? I tell them tenderly. Que sera, sera, whatever will be, the future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera, what will be.
Isn't that the truth? What will be, will be. Back in the saddle again, Gene Autry, the silver screen's first singing cowboy. Ray Whitley, a country singer and actor, wrote the song and introduced it with his group, the Six Bar Cowboys, in 1938 movie, Border G-Man. Soon after, he recorded it as Ray Whitley's Rangers for Decca Records and caught the attention of Autry, who relished the idea of getting back on a trusty horse and riding the range toting an old 44. Whitley and Autry retooled the tune for Autry's next picture, Rovin' Tumbleweeds, in 1939, and the single became his second gold record. He recorded it twice more in 1946 and 1952 and used it as the theme song for his radio program Gene Autry's Melody Ranch and his television show The Gene Autry Show. It was also the title theme to his 1941 film Back in the Saddle. So here we go. Back in the saddle again. Out with a friend is a friend. Where we sleep every night, we're the only love.
right. Back in the saddle again. Riding the range once more. Toting my own 44. Where the longhorn cannot feed on lonely chips and weed. Back in the saddle again. Whoop-dee-tie-yo, rocking to and fro, back in the saddle again. Whoop-dee-tie-yo, be on my way, back in the saddle again. Back in the saddle again.
And that is the classic, right? Gene Autry really, really capitalized on what worked, didn't he? But it worked. I mean, he knew what he was doing, I guess, huh? Okay, I think we have time for one more. I'm going to do one that we have never done before together, and it is The Rose, and is the soundtrack to the feature film of the same name, The Rose, starring Bette Midler, released in 1979. So, The Rose. This will be our last one together today. I hope you've enjoyed, and maybe are feeling up for watching one of these movies now.
Some say love, it is a river that drowns the tender reed. Some say love, it is a razor that leads your soul to bleed. Some say love, it is a hunger and endless aching need. I say love, it is a flower, and you, it's only seed. It's the heart afraid of breaking that never learns to dance. It's the dream afraid of waking that never takes a chance. It's the one who won't be taken, who cannot seem to give, and the soul afraid of dying that never learns to live. When the night has been too lonely and the road has been too long, and you find that love is only for the lucky and the strong, just remember in the winter, beneath the bitter snow, lies the seed that with the sun's love in the spring becomes the rose.
As always, thanks for joining us today, and I will see you next time. Have a great day, everyone. Take care.